class. I am Aman from DPS Hanswani Lamachaur, and today we are going to do the revision for our PT2 exam. And in the syllabus, I have given you only one chapter for the grammar for your PT2 exam, that is adverbs. And this was the recent chapter that we were doing in our Google Meet also. So in the light of the examination schedule on 30th, there will be no Google Meet of English. The Google Meet will be there of the exam that is scheduled for first. So I will now explain you the kinds of adverbs, and we will do the exercise H as I have given that in homework for you. So we have almost covered every exercise, only exercise H was remaining, and I have to explain you that how you will do exercise H and the kinds of adverbs we will revise. So this exercise is a very important one. It will definitely come in your exams. You have to be well prepared for it. But in order to prepare it well, we are going to look back into the chapter, and we are going to revise the adverbs of the kinds of adverbs. I hope that you are preparing well for your PT2 exam. The PT2 exam's format is quite similar with the Hapeli. This time only you will have you will not have the oral, or the marks won't be doubled or anything like that. The pattern will be very easy. 20 marks paper would be there, and the marks would be allotted to you then and there. So the 20 marks paper, English paper, will have first of all the unseen passage, then the grammar, the adverbs, then the literature. For literature, I have given you expert detectives, mystery of the talking pen, and invention of Peter Wong. So I believe these are the chapters. You can check back in the syllabus also once. So now we are going to revise the adverbs of manner. First of all, kinds of adverbs. The adverbs of manner tell us how something happens. In exercise H, it is given that you have to circle the adverb in each sentence and write whether the adverb is describing how, when, or where an action is taking place. So when you have to first of all circle the adverb in the sentence, then you have to write whether it is answering the question of how or when or where. So we have here adverbs of manner, so it answers the question of how. So we will see what are the adverbs of manner, what are the adverbs used as adverbs of manner. And eventually we will get to know that how it answers the question of how, and you have to do just that in exercise H. So let's see. The adverbs of manner tell us how something happens, okay, that how it is happening. They are usually placed either after the main verb or after the object. The main verb, the verbs you all know, like play, read, sing, dance, etc. So these are placed either after the adverb, after the main verb, sorry, or after the object, okay, the thing. Few examples we have. He swims well. So after the verb it is written, he swims well, okay. And now see, he ran quickly. She spoke softly. James coughed loudly. He plays the flute beautifully. So after the direct object, here the adverb is. In above examples, it was after the it was after the main verb in the first four. Now in the fifth sentence, see, he plays the flute beautifully. So flute beautifully, here flute is an object, so after the object. He ate the chocolate cakes greedily. After the direct object, here we have the adverb. Now we have something more of the adverb of manner. Adverb of manner cannot be put between a verb and its direct object. The adverb must be placed either before the verb or at the end of the clause. So it can't come between the verb and the object. See how? He ate greedily the chocolate. It is incorrect. So he ate greedily the chocolate. Here the chocolate is the object and ate is the verb. So it is incorrect. How it will be? He ate the chocolate cake greedily. After the direct object, you have to put. He greedily ate the chocolate, or before the verb you can put. He gave us generously the money. Again, he gave us verb and the money object, direct object, so it is incorrect. He gave us the money generously. After the direct verb, you can put the adverb. He generously gave us the money. Again, before the verb, you can put the adverb. But in between the object and the verb, adverbs cannot be put. Now see, if there is a preposition before the verb's object, you can place the adverb of manner. If there is a preposition before the verb's object, you can place the adverb of manner either before the preposition or after the object. How? See, the child ran happily towards his mother. So towards is the preposition, the direction where the child ran. If the preposition is before the verb's object, verb's object is mother. The child ran towards his mother. So object of the verb is his mother, ran. And you can place the adverb of manner either before the preposition or after the object. So after the before the preposition, the adverb happily is there. The child ran towards his mother happily. So after the object, object is mother. So after the object also you can put the adverb. So basically what you have to understand is, it tells us in the manner, quickly, confidently, politely, hungrily, what more can be there, confidently, gently, softly, loudly, all these are the example of adverbs of manner, and they answer the question how. So you have to find it in the exercise H. Adverbs of manner should always come immediately after the verbs which have no object. When there is no object in the sentence, it should come directly after the verb. See, the town grew quickly after 1997. So here no object is there, simple statement is there, so it will come immediately after the verb. He waited patiently for his mother to arrive. He waited patiently, for his mother to arrive. So after waited, after the verb, patiently is there. These common adverbs of manner are almost always placed directly after the verb. Well, badly, hard and fast. He swam well. It always comes after the verb. The rain fell hard. It comes almost after the verb. Always after the verb. Now see, adverb of time. So adverb of time tells us the question of when. It answers the question of when. Adverb of manner was answering the question of how, and time is answering the question of when. Adverbs that change or qualify the meaning of a sentence by telling us when things happen are defined as adverbs of time. adverbs that change or qualify the meaning of a sentence by telling us when things happen. Okay, so it is very easy that it tells us of the time of the action taking place. An adverb of time is just what you might expect it to be, a word that describes when, for how long, for how often a certain action happened. So whichever word is defining that, what was the duration, what was the timing, it will be adverb of time. You will notice that many adverbs of time are the same as adverbs of frequency. Adverbs of frequency tells us that how often it happens. There is quite a bit of overlap between these two types of adverbs, so much so that some instructors choose to mention one or the other but not both. Okay, so it will be asked in the question only one kind, because there is a confusion between both. Okay, there are simple rules of adverbs of time that will make you use them in the right way. So adverbs of time often work best when placed at the end of the sentence. So adverb of time is always almost every time placed at the end of the sentence. Robin Hood swindled the sheriff of Nottingham yesterday. Okay, so yesterday is the adverb of time, when the action happened. I am sick of living in chaos, so I am going to clean my house tomorrow. So tomorrow is the adverb of time, and it is placed at the end of the sentence. You can change the position of an adverb of time to lend emphasis to a certain aspect of a sentence. How? You can change it also. You can change the position also. Like, later, Robin Hood stole the king's crown. Okay, this is one example. The time is the most important element here. Later, that when it happened later. Robin Hood, first of all, in the sentence it was there, in the example it was there, that Robin Hood swindled the sheriff yesterday. Then later he stole the king's crown. Now we can put later in other part of sentence also. See, Robin Hood later stole. Okay, first of all we were using later Robin Hood stole. We are now saying Robin Hood later stole. This is a formal use of adverb later. Okay, Robin Hood stole the king's crown later. So at the end also later can be put. So every way is correct. These simple rules of adverbs will help you to use them in the right way. So it is the third kind, and the adverb of place, as you can understand, it tells us about the place. So it answers the question of where. So adverb of place always talks about the location where the action of the verb is being carried out. Adverb of place are normally placed after a sentence, object or main verb. So it is either after the main verb or the object. Adverb of place can be directional. It can tell us about the direction, that whether the action is taking place up, down, around, away, north, south, east, like this. Adverb of place can refer to distances, for example, nearby, far away, miles apart. Okay, it can tell us about the distances also. So few examples of adverbs we have, and each sentence is having one example. It has been italicized. Italicized means it is in italics, and italics means the words written in slanting to the right direction. See, put the cake there. So there is the adverb here. So it tells us the direction. After a long day at work, we headed homeward. So homewards is the place. So it may be a new word for you. Please bring that book here. So here is also a verb, adverb. And it tells us the question. It answers the question of where. So my grandfather's house is nearby. So nearby also tells us about a place. Okay, so these are few examples. Now coming to your exercise H. So you have to circle the adverb in each sentence and write whether the adverb is describing how, when, where an action is taking place. So since it was raining, The boys played inside. So here, what is the adverb? The adverb is inside. So inside tells us, answers the question of where. So second, the people were sitting in the courtyard. So courtyard is a place, you will mark it, and it answers the question where. I waited patiently for the door to open. So patiently, and it answers the question of how. Fourth, the thief ran through the crowd. Through tells us the direction. So it is answering the question of where. My little sister was hiding behind the tree. Okay, so it is here. Behind is telling the direction. Okay, so it answers the question of where. Rajesh can run faster than Ravi. So faster is the adverb here, and it answers the question of how. Jason politely asked for coffee. So politely is the adverb here, and it answers the question of how. So I hope that these sentences are clear to you, and this way only in exam it will come. What you need to do is you need to revise the chapter once more. You can watch the video again, you can read the chapter, you can read the adverbs, and you can easily do the exercises. So all the best for your PT2 exams, and learn well. Only adverbs is there for grammar, so it won't be much for you. Just learn the chapter very carefully, revise the literature portion, and carefully attempt the reading section as well. So I am Aman from DPS Haldwani Lamachaur. You are watching PTO classes. All the best for your PT2 exams, and thank you so much.